The gift that looks good on you.
You are born with a grace.
Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the relaunch of With Christ I Can, with God All Things Are Possible. I am so excited to have my special guest with me here today, Tissa Rose. Oh my goodness, she has a powerful testimony. But before we get started, we are going to go into a word of prayer because we need God to do anything. We know that without Him, we are nothing.
Yes.
So let's just bow our heads. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you so much just for who you are. We thank you for bringing us to this point at this time, oh God. We thank you for the vision that you have given us, oh God. Lord, we thank you for the testimonies. Lord, we thank you for what you've brought us through. Yes. God, we give you all glory, honor, and praise. Lord, we ask that you bless our viewers, yes, those who will hear this show on today, God, in the future. Lord, just have your way, oh God. Lord, you can transcend technology. Lord, you can prick the hearts even through the television screen. And we just thank you and we praise you. We're so excited about what you're going to do. Yes. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. So Tanesha, I'm so glad that you're here with us. I want you to just tell us a little bit about yourself.
So my name is Tanesha. I am a florist. My floral is Tissa Rose. I go out to schools. I also deliver many arrangements. I have a website. You can look me up at www.tissarose.net, and I would love to hear from you.
All right. Amen. So you're a florist. What made you want to become a florist?
Let's back up a little bit. I was a cosmetologist. I am a licensed cosmetologist, but I put that to the side. And it was just a season I was in.
Okay.
And God used floral to help me to heal and go, you know, I was going through some things. And floristry was my healing. It was my peace. It was my comfort.
Okay.
Yes.
So you were a cosmetologist. You didn't mention it, but you also had a clothing line or have a clothing line, Believer.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that.
So Believer brand, it really, it's a whole with my brand, you can be next, LLC.
Okay.
So that means Believer, I do floral, and like I said, I'm a cosmetologist. So you know the God that we serve, the doors are always open.
That's right,
the options
that's right.
are open all the time. So we don't have to, you know, hold ourselves back. But at this point, I had to like put that to the side for now, just for a little bit. And floristry just became my passion. Like God gave me a passion and I could never, you know, had gotten there without Him. But I was in that season. I was in a deep place and He just helped me to heal, helped me to grow, helped me to see things from a different perspective through flowers.
Okay. All right. So how long have you been in the floral industry?
So I always loved flowers.
Mm-hmm.
Now I decided to, you know, put it on paper and get everything legit.
Right.
Maybe a good year ago. Yes, everything is legit. So, yeah, I would say that. But I have been in floristry forever, like just doing arrangements, keeping them around the house,
mm-hmm.
you know, putting them in my children's room. And sometimes we also create arrangements together.
Okay. All right. So you kept saying that flowers bring healing. Can you dig a little deeper into that? What does that mean? It brings healing.
So for me, God created the grass, the trees, the flowers,
mm-hmm.
you know. So I begin to just find healing by touching it, looking at the different colors. It's sensory, you know what I mean? And it just brings me to a place when I'm working with the flowers, working with my hands. I'm like, wow, first of all, how am I even doing this? Because I don't have, you know, I didn't go to school. So
right,
it's God. It's a gift from God that I'm able to create and use my hands, but also use the flowers that He created. So that brings healing. Now I'm able to want to learn and read and take courses and things like that to better myself in floristry.
Okay. And even as well, you talk about God created the flowers and plants and things like that. if you go into science, and I'm not, I was a teacher, touched on science a little bit, but I'm an English teacher by trade. That's why we have to get out in nature and fresh air and all that. So yes, I love it. So what, you said you've been in the industry for about a good year, or, you know, you've been licensed for about a good year. What's the greatest success that you've ever had in this business so far?
The greatest success so far has been me being able to go on a college campus. So I am a vendor with Widener University. Beautiful. So that was like a goal I never even seen for myself, but I stepped out of my comfort zone and I went for it. And now, you know, I have other schools contacting me and I'm talking to them. So I'm just walking by faith and believing God and everything that I do. So that was really huge for me to go on to that campus. And I was able to just bring the flowers. I came with buckets of flowers and able to show them that, you know, it's a stress buster. It's also, I'm not there to overload them, but help them to relax and decompress, because it's sensory. You're touching it. You see the different colors, you know, things like that.
That's beautiful. That's beautiful. So I want to know what, or why is customer service important? Because you talked about going on college campuses, and I know people probably contact you for funerals and birthdays and Valentine's Day and all the things. Why is customer service a part of what you do? Why is having good customer service part of what you do?
Customer service is really, really important because, remember, we are serving. So I want to make sure I'm connecting, listening to my consumer, hearing what they have to say, and making sure I'm meeting their needs, and not only that, building a relationship so that they can come back, you know, and they know they can trust me, building that trust in that relationship. So customer service means a lot because we're serving one another.
That's good. So you're not just giving them the flowers and walking off.
I'm not just giving them the flowers and walking off. And another thing, it is me, they're choosing me because it's not support, it's choosing. So I'm grateful for them to choose me, little old me, you know. It's so many different floral shops out there, but they chose Tissa Rose. So that makes me, you know, that brings joy to me. So I love to serve my customer because they chose me.
That's beautiful. And you said that the name of your company is Tissa Rose. What gave you that idea?
Oh, here we go.
Why'd you come up with that name?
So my mother, rest her soul, you know, her name was Santisa.
Okay.
And Santisa, she had a pure heart. My mother, she was loving. She always would compliment you. She always looked nice, and she always wanted to give, you know. And my mother suffered from a mental illness. My mother was schizophrenic my whole life. So, you know, just me wanting to keep her name alive. So Tissa Rose, you know, I will give my mother flowers too when she was alive. So that just brings me peace. You know, Tissa, Santisa, everybody know that's Santisa, Tissa Rose. That's how I came up with that, to keep her name alive.
That's beautiful. So the legacy is still living on. That is beautiful.
Yes.
And many more people are being blessed just from what she's done with you.
Yes.
That's beautiful.
Thank you.
All right. So what parts of the job, because we know with anything that we do, it takes work, is difficult or may push you out of your comfort zone?
Okay, I'm going to be transparent. So the thing that would push me and be uncomfortable, an uncomfortable place, is just like where God has me. I'm on a certain journey. And when you're on a journey, people will just be coming from every which way trying to pull you, not knowing the prayers that I prayed, you know. And it might be to them like, I need you to do this, I want you to do that, but I'm trying to stay focused to God. So it makes me uncomfortable. That's the most uncomfortable thing, when you can't meet the needs of people around you. They want you to meet their need, but God has me on a path. You know, so I have to stick to the path that God has me on, and not what other people want me to do, not what they want, but what God wants. Because Tissa Rose's hands are blessed by the Most High God.
Amen.
So I have to stick to what he gave me.
All right. So we know that flowers are not cheap. Flowers are not cheap.
Tell me right? about it. Please tell me about that. Let's talk about that. Let's talk about it.
Flowers are not cheap. The arrangements. And I've seen your work, right? It's unique. It's Thank nothing you. That we've ever seen before. So how... They're not cheap. So what is the process like? I mean, you know, especially when, you know, you want to be a blessing to somebody, and but it's a cost. How do you navigate that?
So I'll say this. Flowers are not cheap, but I do love to bless others. Mm-hmm. So another, you know, if I happen to have flowers extra sometimes, not all the times, but I'll... You know, sometimes make up so many arrangements and mm-hmm. take them to the local rehabilitation centers in the area.
That's
and
beautiful.
Sometimes I give them to the school, you know, just try to put joy on someone's face. But it's at a cost, definitely. But if it's just like flowers sitting around, I can't do anything with them.
Right.
I am blessed to bless someone else, you know. And I know the times that we are in, flowers make a difference. It might seem like a small gesture, but it brings so much joy to people.
Amen. That's true. That's true. So what is the most crucial thing about your business?
So I'm transparent all the time. So here's another one. So just me growing. Nobody's teaching me. I'm figuring it out mm-hmm. myself. But the times that we are in, you know, is different. So it is possible
mm-hmm.
because I actually had a mentor and, you know, she had to let me go. It may
right.
have been through the economy or whatever the case
right.
may have been. And I understood that I actually didn't go to her for money.
Right,
I
right.
went for the education.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I sat back and I just was able to see how this is, I can figure this out. I can do mm-hmm. all things through Christ who strengthens me.
That's right.
So, you know, that has been, you know, one of the things that I had to overcome, but I'm working it out. God is before me, who could be mm-hmm. against me? And it's just been blessed, you know, because I believe his hand is on it.
That's right.
God's hand, he's in control.
Yes, and you touched on something so profound. I always say that Jesus is the best mentor.
He's the best mentor. He's the best.
Yes, he is. Yes, he'll wake you up in the middle of the night, giving you ideas, and yes, definitely, definitely. And I'm so glad that was a great segue into my next question. How does your relationship with Christ play a role in your business?
Woo, Jesus. It plays a huge role in my business. It plays a huge role in my everyday life.
That's
so
right.
I know that I cannot do anything without him.
Yeah.
So prayer, fasting, you know, going to service, staying mm-hmm. in community, staying in the church,
yes.
reading my word and encouraging myself daily, because entrepreneurship and having a business is not for the faint at heart at all. So you really have to know how to encourage yourself on the days when you have one like or share or no likes at all, or one cell or 10 cells, be mm-hmm. also ready. Be ready. You know what I want? I want to be ready all the time. So that's like, let me stay prayed up no matter what it is, so my heart posture can be in the proper place. And it doesn't matter if somebody doesn't buy something from me, I won't take it personal, because
mm-hmm.
to be a business owner, you have to have that skin.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can't be moved by much. You have to stay focused on what God has for you. I know that's my testimony. I must stay focused. I can't let the small things around me, you know, break me down. So I just stay encouraged through that, the word of God, prayer, fasting, believing, singing,
yeah,
worshiping.
Oh yeah, they don't know that she can sing. She can sing too.
Yes, I'm
very
always
talented,
encouraging myself,
yes,
because it's not easy. Do
yeah.
not, you know, I'm telling you, it's not easy. You have to stick it out. Stay consistent. Keep posting. They're watching you. People are watching.
Mm-hmm.
They're watching.
True.
They see.
That's true.
Consistency.
So do you talk a lot about your fasting, praying, going to service? Do your customers know that you are a believer? And if so, because you're going on college campuses, you're going to different venues and vendors here and there,
mm-hmm.
right? do they know? How do you show Christ to unbelievers? Because I'm pretty sure everybody that you encounter is not a Christian.
Absolutely. So everyone, like you said, the college, so I'll give you an example. I went on the campus mm-hmm. and the jars that I made up had encouraging messages on them. Mm-hmm. So they know me by my heart. Mm-hmm. That's how. You know, they can tell if I don't say anything, they know it's something different about this girl right mm-hmm. here. It's something different about her. So, you know, I'm on the campus and it's like they are encouraged by the messages that I had on the jars, and they were uplifted by just me, my presence. And I was complimenting them, mm-hmm. asking them how long have they been here, just giving them love and showing them that I care. Because right. the times that we are in, you have to make sure, you know. Like, the pandemic took a toll on many people. Many people yes. have changed. They are not the same anymore. So just that you can make it. Yes. You know what I mean? Be encouraged. Smile today. Don't lose hope. You got this. Those were some of the messages on the jars. And that was, you know, that was one of the things that I did. And they could know that I'm a believer that way. So it's like when I encounter different rooms, different settings, they will know. I also do parties. Okay. So if I'm in a setting with a party, then they will definitely know, because now I'm able to talk mm-hmm. more in the room. Tell them, like you asked me, how did I get into floristry and what brought it on? I'm able to share my testimony that way with many different people, walks of life, not just Christians either, because sometimes, right. you know, we come into contact with other religions. That's but true. People are people, but they know by my heart, my posture.
Amen. So it sounds like, to me, you're saying we have to show Christ, Amen. Right? More so than just saying, oh, I'm a Christian. Amen. It is how you treat people.
How we treat people. Right. We are known by the fruits
That's right.
that we bear, you know?
That's right.
Our fruits.
Right. That's beautiful. All right. So what advice would you offer to someone who's interested in going into this industry?
Floristry? I would say, if you love it, go for it. If you want to try it, try it. I know me, I would never think that this would be something, you know, that I'm making a career out of, like a right. passion. Like, right. I don't even have to turn back to cosmetology at all, because every time I'm creating, it doesn't feel like I'm working. Mm. It just feels like God is with me every right. time. And I know for some people, they might not understand it, but it brought so much peace to my life. Mm-hmm. I mean, I have peace through Christ Jesus, but like right, I right. said, he created these flowers that I'm working with. Mm-hmm. So now I'm able to just, you know, be filled with joy. And not only that, like, it's so many different colors. God gave us everything we need down to the sensory. Like the grass, the trees, the water. We can look up at the sky, see the sunshine, and that is God. Mm-hmm. And not only is it God, but it helps us mentally. Mm-hmm. It helps us mentally.
That's right. Amen. That's right. So tell us, because I know that you have some events coming up in the near future. What is yeah. next week, the 19th? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. So tell us a little bit about your events that are coming up.
So I have an event. It's called Pretty Petals Botanical Experience. Okay. And it's basically a floral workshop. So you okay. get together with your friends, your family, and you'll be able to learn how to create your very own botanical arrangement. So mm-hmm. I'm going to walk you through the steps so that you could make your own centerpiece for Thanksgiving. You know, you don't have to call me because you came to the workshop right. and now you know the steps. And if you need one for Christmas, listen, if you want to do your own wedding, mm-hmm. you know, I'm giving you the basics on how to create your flowers, to keep them healthy, to keep them clean. Things that people really don't know, because they're not thinking about it. They're just like, oh, let me just plop these flowers in a vase. But that's not how that's it goes. It.
Right.
That's
right.
not the way. So, yeah, that will be November the 18th.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then I have another event November the 19th, which okay. will be at the historical Bartram Gardens. And that is actually free for the okay. family, and just come out with your kids and everything. So, yeah. I think it's from 11 to 2 at Bartram Gardens.
Okay. So you have the workshop, the botanical
yes,
experience.
That Friday.
And that Friday. And then that Saturday you have the event at Bartram Gardens.
Yes.
And something you said that I really want to touch on, because it shows your heart. You said you teach them how to do it so that they can, if they want to make their own centerpieces or they want to make their own stuff. A lot of people are not like that. They're like, just call me, right? They don't want to teach you mm-hmm. how to do things. But I think that's beautiful, and that's a ministry in itself, because mm-hmm. you are creating a legacy. Like, what good is it if I'm the only one who knows how to do it and nobody else does?
So our gifts are not just for us. Mm-hmm. We're to share them.
That's right.
So I can't keep what God gave me. I'm going to share it. Yes. So I think that, you know, if I can just help somebody else, and maybe they want to be a florist, I have mm-hmm. no problem with showing you the basics.
Right.
I mean, if you have a passion for it, that's good too.
Right.
Because it won't even feel like work to you. You'll want to learn, absorb more information, and learn different things about floristry that yeah. way.
Yes. That's beautiful. And this is something to our audience members, like, this is something that, you know, if you have a women's group, a church group, or mm-hmm. Mother's Day.
Bridal showers.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is something that you want to reach out to Tissa Rose, and we want you to tell us how we can get in contact with you, you know, moving forward, if we want to reach out, or even if we just want you to come do a workshop or just something, even talk to us, right? Even okay. encourage us, because she yes. is an encourager
Amen.
As well.
Amen.
Right?
Through the grace of God, yes.
Yeah, so tell us where we can find you.
You can find me on Instagram at _TissaRose. That's Instagram. So you also can find me at www.tissa.net. That's my website, and you can leave me an email, you know, and I'll respond to you. You'll also be able to see everything that I offer. Everything is listed online, and I'll definitely get back to you at my earliest convenience. Definitely, yes. So through the website. But follow me on Instagram, _TissaRose.
That's beautiful. And Tanesha, she's doing wonderful things. She's cosmetologist, clothing line, floristry, singer, minister, all the things, right? All the things, all wrapped up in one. But God is so good.
God is
a fashionista, like, God is good. And like, your gifts will make room for you,
Amen.
Right? Your gifts will definitely make room for you. I'm sure there's days when you've been discouraged, right? You felt like you didn't want to continue, but he just showed up and showed out and is always making a way.
Amen.
So to somebody who is watching, somebody who has been encouraged, I just want you to offer them a word of prayer, right?
All right.
Let God use you, whatever's
yes.
on your heart.
Yes. Thank you. I just want to say thank you, Lord, for thank all you. That you have done, God. And I want to just say, anybody that is watching this, Lord, I ask that you give them the strength, oh God. Let them know that they can do it. They
yes,
can do
Lord.
All things through Christ who strengthens them, Lord. So get up and wait no longer. Get that LLC
yes,
in Jesus' name.
Yes, yes.
Get up and get that paperwork filed in Jesus' name. They may
yes.
not know how they're going to pay for it, oh God, but you make a way
yes,
out of no way, Lord.
Yes,
so
God.
I ask
thank
that you make a way, oh God, and provide the resources for them in the name of Jesus. And even if they need help, oh God, they can email me, Lord, and I will help them, and I will get them the information that they need to know. Lord, I ask that you keep their families, Lord God. I
yes,
ask
sir.
That you bless and heal minds, oh God.
Yes,
people
sir.
Who are suffering with depression, Lord
yes,
God.
Sir.
I ask that you move it, oh God. Right
yes,
now it is rebuked in the name of Jesus. Devils have to flee in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you, oh God, for this fellowship today.
Yes,
we
Lord.
Thank you for this opportunity today, Lord God, and we know that it is blessed, Lord. I ask
yes,
that you
sir.
Bless everyone that is watching, Lord God, and I ask that you give them a sound mind.
Yes,
in
Lord.
Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Beautiful. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank God. We thank you all for
yes.
watching. We
thank
pray
you.
That you were blessed. We know that you were blessed.
Yes, yes.
And stay tuned, all right? Stay tuned for more guests, more testimonies. With God, all things are possible.
Amen.
Be blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You were born with a grace.
The gift that looks good on you.
That grace is your gift. Yeah.
The gift that looks good on you.
It's a divine enablement.
The gift that looks good on you.
If you work your grace, the grace will work for you. Company, teach the lesson.
The systems of the world will try to take your